of the monosaccharides. So the monosaccharide properties is very important in that mutar rotation is one, and reducing property and osazone formation. I will tell you only about mutar rotation. And under reducing property I will talk about the Benedict's test and its significance. So mutar rotation, if you see, the important property that is seen in case of monosaccharides, important property that is seen in case of monosaccharides is mutar rotation. The change in specific rotation of an optically active solution without any change in other properties is called mutar rotation. So mutar rotation means the change in the specific optical rotation of a solution without any change in other properties, without any change in other properties is called mutar rotation. So what will happen? There will be a change in the rotation of optical activity of the particular solution, but all other properties will remain same. So this phenomenon is called as mutar rotation. This mutar rotation is exhibited by carbohydrates, monosaccharides especially. For example, you take here glucose, D-glucose as an example. Now D-glucose has two enomers which we have already studied. That is alpha D-glucose and beta D-glucose. So D-glucose has two enomers, that is alpha D-glucose and beta D-glucose. Two forms are there, you know that. Now when you prepare this D-glucose in a water, making a D-glucose solution, what will happen in the solution? After some time, what happens? There is a state called equilibrium state is attained in the solution when you mix this D-glucose in the water. Now after some time they attain a state called equilibrium state, and at the equilibrium state what happens is about 1/3 molecules are alpha D glucose types, you will see, and about 2/3 molecules are of beta type of D glucose is seen. So the optic rotation at equilibrium, if you measure for this D glucose solution, this will be around 52.5 degree will be there. So initially if you see alpha D glucose, you are originally preparing this D glucose solution, okay. So this D glucose solution is open chain structure, whereas alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are cyclic ring structures of the glucose. So what happens when you take the freshly prepared D-glucose solution, its optical rotation is around 52.5 degree. So when you take an alpha D-glucose solution, suppose let's say you have taken alpha D-glucose solution and you have measured the optical activity, for alpha D-glucose what happens? The optical rotation is 112 degree. And for beta D glucose, the optical rotation is about plus 19 degree. But when you keep this alpha D glucose solution or beta D glucose solution for 5-6 hours, or let's say for 1 day you have kept this solution in the refrigerator, and you took the solution the next day or the other day, what happens? The optical rotation, it is not either 112 degree or it is not either plus 19 degree. Surprisingly, the optical rotation of the solution becomes 52.5 degree. Let's say you have prepared alpha D glucose solution first day and its optic rotation is plus 112 degree. But after 1 day what happens? The optical rotation has changed to 52.5 degree. How this optical activity is changed like this, the scientists have thought. Then they have understood that the interconversion of alpha D glucose to beta D glucose takes place via D glucose formation. So the cyclic forms are interconvertible. These two are interconvertible. They change automatically during the course of time. But after attaining the equilibrium, there will be 36% of alpha D glucose and 64% of beta D glucose will be there. Only my less amount of D glucose will be there, less amount of open chain glucose ring structure is seen. And at the equilibrium, the optic rotation will be around 50 plus 52.5 degree. It is neither plus 112 degree nor plus 19 degree. 19 degree means it should be beta D. If it is plus 112 degree means it should be alpha D. It is not neither plus 112 nor plus 19 degree, so that the optical rotation, if you assess, it is 52.5 degree. So this change in optical rotation of sugar molecules or monosaccharides is called as Nutter rotation. Nutter rotation means change in the specific optical rotation of a sugar solution without affecting the other properties of the compound is called Nutter rotation. So for D-glucose at equilibrium, the Nutter rotation is around plus 52.5 degree.